India's largest mutual fund, HDFC Mutual Fund, is in serious trouble. After SEBI charged the mutual fund house with front-running by one of its dealers, it now appears that the scale of the fraud was actually much bigger. A fresh show-cause notice by the market regulator reveals how this dealer was running amok. What is even more startling is the fact that the fund house failed to control it, and even after a few years of the alleged front-running, doesn't seem to have a grip on the extent to which its investors were defrauded by this rogue dealer. In this special report, we bring you details of the front-running scandal at HDFC Mutual Fund. Our team of reporters, Swati and Saloni, join me now to reveal the scandal. Swati, first up, take us through how SEBI's latest show-cause notice brings back an issue from HDFC Mutual Fund's past that continues to haunt it.
Well, Vivek, the capital market regulator has slapped a fresh show-cause notice on HDFC AMC with regard to a front-running case, which you're talking about, which saw SEBI releasing multiple orders both in 2010 and 2011. We are in possession of the show-cause notice dated 20th of March, which points out more front-running trades as opposed to 62 trades that HDFC AMC that submitted in 2011 to SEBI. SEBI's investigation has actually unearthed and revealed 109 cases of front running between the 2006 to 7 period in which dealer Nilesh Kaparia facilitated front running trades. In fact, all three parties involved, which is HDFC AMC, HDFC Trustee Company and Milind Barve, the MD of HDFC AMC, face further trouble. Back to you.
Swati, how is HDFC Mutual Fund responding to this fresh charge by SEBI that the front-running scandal was much bigger than what the company had disclosed earlier?
Well, in response to our query, Vivek, HDFC AMC has replied, and I quote, they say, this issue relates to the same alleged misconduct of the same dealer, Nilesh Kaparia, who is no longer with the organization since June 2010. We are in the process of resolving the issues with the regulator in accordance with SEBI rules. Quote end.
All right, let's go across to Saloni now. Saloni, SEBI's 2010 order goes into great detail on how this rogue dealer, Nilesh Kaparia, had created a big web that ran a front-running racket via other market participants.
Well, clearly, Vivek, this entire episode dates back to the period of 2006-2007 when Nilesh Kaparia, who was the mastermind behind these trades, was the assistant vice president of equities of HDFC AMC. Now, SEBI's order that was issued in 2010 revealed that Nilesh Kaparia shared confidential information with Rajiv Ramnik Lal Sanghvi, who equipped to front-running HDFC's AMC order. In fact, Kaparia helped Sanghvi make substantial gains via front running. The probe also revealed that Rajiv Sanghvi traded in his own name on NSE while used Chandrakant Mehta, another accused name, while trading on the BSE. In fact, SEBI also noted that Sanghvi reported back with details like the quantity and the price to Kaparia after conducting these trades. Back to you.
All right, so how did all of this begin? Saloni, take us through what the 2010 investigation uncovered.
Well, Vivek, SEBI's probe in 2010 revealed 38 instances of front-running. So how was this executed? Rajiv Sanghvi and Chandrakant Mehta placed buy and sell orders ahead of HDFC AMC. This was later followed by HDFC AMC's buy-sell orders. Both Sanghvi and Mehta made substantial intraday profits by front-running HDFC AMC's trades. In fact, the next big step in this web was that Kaparia postponed the execution of HDFC AMC trades so that Rajiv Sanghvi and Chandrakant Mehta could execute their trades. In fact, trades were postponed even when HDFC AMC's trades could have been executed earlier at a much lower cost. So clearly a web here created to facilitate front running for both Sanghvi and Mehta.
Let me come back to you, Swati. In this fresh show cause notice now, SEBI is also accusing HDFC Asset Management of not running the mutual fund arm and the portfolio management arm independently, letting information leak to the detriment of a portfolio client, isn't it?
Well, yes, Vivek, even the portfolio management services offered by HDFC AMC in this period have been questionable. SEBI's investigation has unearthed that portfolio client Sudhir Enterprises trades were front-run. In fact, Nilesh Kaparia, who acted as a dealer, passed on the client information to the other accused like Chandrakant Mehta and Rajiv Sanghvi. SEBI's probe revealed that the AMC did not maintain high standards in client dealings and created portfolio loss to its PMS clients. SEBI, in its show cause notice, further noted that HDFC AMC has violated portfolio management regulations despite claiming that the mutual fund and PMS services were managed independently.
All right, so now for a second time, HDFC Asset Management as a corporate entity, its trustee company and its top management are being hauled up again. What are the charges that they are facing this time? Saloni, take us through what the corporate entity is being pulled up for.
Clearly the show cause notice has made some sharp and damning observations on the way the entire front-running episode was handled by HDFC AMC, HDFC Trustee Company and even the senior management. Now, SEBI has noted that the company did not ensure that all regulations were met when conducting these trades. In fact, SEBI probe also revealed that the company submitted wrong certificate to the capital market regulator and did not report any front-running activity to the regulator. SEBI noted that not only did the senior management fail to detect these irregularities, but also failed to prevent information leak to outside parties, due to which SEBI came to the conclusion that both the companies and its senior management did not maintain any high due diligence standards. Back to you.
And Saloni, what does this mean for HDFC Asset Management CEO Milind Barve? He comes in for serious criticism as well in this new show cause notice.
Clearly Milind Barve now, who is the president and managing director of the AMC, is facing heat. Now, in the show cause notice, SEBI has noted that Milind Barve didn't ensure that the asset management company complied with all regulations. In fact, Barve now faces a second probe in this matter. Barve is also the ex-chairman of AMFI. Barve was also on the SEBI's new insider trading committee norms, and now he is also on a SEBI's radar.
Swati, just to understand what action HDFC, AMC and its management faces now, tell us what action was taken on all these entities back in 2010?
Well, after that order, we saw HDFC Asset Management approach SEBI to close the matter, what it thought would be once and for all. What were the terms of that consent agreement is something that we are watching out for.
Saloni, let me get back to you. After that order, HDFC Asset Management did approach SEBI to close the matter. But what now? The rules have changed, isn't it?
Clearly, Vivek, just to run you through to begin with the consent order. Now, this was released in 2011 post the 2010 order, which clearly said that all the three related parties, the AMC, the trustee co and the senior management had failed comply with the due diligence norms. It says it had further directed all these three parties. So HDFC AMC paid 20 lakh rupees, HDFC trustee co paid 20 lakh rupees, while Milind Barve was directed to pay 15 lakh rupees. So in all, 55 lakh rupees were paid to settle these norms. But clearly what now changes the picture is that the present norms do not for serious offences like insider trading and front running and violation of listing norms, consent norms do not apply and are non-consentable. So clearly this largely changes the story of what ahead that lies for all these three interested parties. Back to you.
Swati, I want to come back to you to just sum up the new show cause notice. What it's really in effect saying is that there were more than 100 further suspect transactions in addition to the 30 odd that had been covered earlier in the order, which means that some of these transactions are actually three times more the number of transactions that already seem to be closed still need closure. Now, that is a serious charge, isn't it?
Absolutely serious charge. In fact, SEBI has slapped this show cause notice. And just to take you through it once again, this is on HDFC AMC on a front-running case, which SEBI saw releasing multiple orders both in 2010 and 2011. We, of course, have this show cause notice with us, which is dated 20th March, very clearly pointing out to the front-running trades as opposed to the 62 trades that HDFC AMC that submitted in 2011 to SEBI. Now, this investigation by SEBI has revealed 109 cases of front-running between the period of 2006 and 2007, in which dealer Nilesh Kaparia facilitated front-running trades. In fact, all three parties involved, which is HDFC AMC, HDFC Trustee Company and Milind Barve, the MD of HDFC AMC, face further trouble.
Special coverage of the massive front-running scandal that brings serious trouble to India's largest mutual fund, HDFC Mutual Fund. Joining me now is Sandeep Parikh, a securities lawyer, well-known securities lawyer, who's also earlier served as an executive director at SEBI. He's also the founder of FinSec Law Advisors. Thank you very much, Sandeep, for joining me. First of all, I want to understand from you, given the new consent norms that SEBI put out, can cases of insider trading and front running now be settled between an accused and the regulator?
I think the seeming and clear answer seems to be that they cannot be settled, because under the new consent norms, which of course I don't fully agree with them, but they are the current law, the insider trading cases, front-running cases, cannot be consented to at all. But in the context of this case, I'm not very sure if to the extent that there's a kind of charge of poor supervision, whether that can be consented or not. But broadly speaking, anything related to insider trading or front-running can no longer be consented. Of course, we have the case of Reliance, which is pending in SAT, where they kind of filed it in that grey period. And they wanted to kind of continue with consent. That's still kind of pending ruling by SAT. But broadly, anything kind of brought today will not be entertained. It's a reasonably clear position.
Sandeep, what is the accountability in a situation where one of your dealers or one of your employees has indulged not once, but now, as we know, more than 150 times in such acts? Where does the accountability lie as per the regulations and norms?
No, so the regulations are reasonably clear in terms of accountability lying with the company. But I think part of the job is really, I mean, there are two aspects to this, really. One is preventive, and the other is kind of, as is criminal law, is called retributive. That preventive means that you create systems in place, for instance, you make sure that any calls made from the dealing room or from the system do not really escape, or if any kind of misconduct happens, it's telephone lines are recorded, there are jammers installed. So there are all these kind of preventive norms which are applicable. And the other is, you can outlaw murder, but that is not going to stop murders from occurring. So that is, you put somebody in jail, you send them to jail for 100 years, 50 years, whatever. So that is kind of the other end of dealing with it. So it clearly has to be a combination of both of these. And insider trading, of course, over the past several years, I think it is, there have been a lot of cases worldwide. Most famous being the Rajat Gupta Rajaratnam case in the US. So I think there is much more active interest in going after insider trading cases, even in India. And this is, I think, these are the signs of the time in terms of more actions.
When you say the accountability lies with the company, we did see in the 2010 order that SEBI passed, even the managing director of the AMC had to have a separate consent that he had to do with the regulator. As per the law, as per the current norms, where does the accountability in terms of the position held lie as far as front-running or these kind of charges against a mutual fund is concerned, Sandeep?
So to put it kind of rather bluntly, I think the accountability does lie with the company. There is no specific provision which says it lies with either the board of directors or the managing director. It lies with the company itself, broadly speaking. Having said that, I think this has been probably a fairly unique case in terms of going after the managing director, even though the managing director is not personally involved in kind of any misconduct. So what they seem to have gone under is poor supervision, really. So it's a very common case used by the US SEC to go against top management to say that you did not properly supervise, you did not have proper checks and balances in place, you do not have, for example, proper phone jammers or whatever else in place. So you did not create sufficient mechanisms to prevent this crime. So I think they're kind of going after that in terms of the top management, including managing director. But on the other hand, the criminal law, the contributive aspect, they have to obviously go against the people who have committed the offense.
Just to go into some details, Sandeep, which are coming out of this show cause. And again, we are talking on the larger issue here. In the first time, or the first instance when the order was passed, there were about 30-odd suspect transactions which had come to light. The regulator had told the AMC at that time to conduct its own investigation to see if there were further violations, and some 60-odd transactions, further transactions, were submitted. Now the regulator's own investigation shows a number of 109, which means that this rogue dealer was clearly running amok. It wasn't about a few transactions here or there. It was a seriously compromised situation, isn't it?
Yes. So I think this is based on what information I've heard from you and your colleagues. I have not seen the show cause notice. But it seems that the scale was much bigger. I think the scope has also been expanded a little bit. But broadly, it was, I think, the scale has been much bigger. So I would assume that there would be kind of levels of compensation are kind of bound to increase if kind of the scale has been much larger. So the mutual fund shareholders or unit holders will likely be compensated much more. I assume that they will not really kind of go after the same top management for poor supervision again, given that they've kind of already consented for lack of control in the past. So I'm not very sure that case will be reopened as of today, but I may be wrong on that.
But the consent was more specific to those transactions. Here are three times more transactions, fresh transactions, which have come to light. So perhaps there would be scope to go beyond that consent. But my final question to you, Sandeep, is there under the law today, I know that SEBI came out with even some kind of a guidelines on class action suits. Is there a scope? Because nobody here is talking about the investor. When this rogue dealer was going out there trying to do or actually indulging in this kind of a front running, there were genuine investors who perhaps suffered, who if he gained, they were the ones who were suffering. Is there a scope for investors who have actually suffered to actually be compensated?
So I don't know this for a fact, but typically SEBI kind of, at least in the consent mechanism, typically SEBI would impose an order of disgorgement or something like that against the wrongdoers, not against, for lack of supervision. So I'm assuming that in the 2010-11 orders, they did kind of pass an order asking the wrongdoers to pay compensation to the fund itself, which of course the numbers will go up dramatically if, as you say, the number of trades has been much more. So I think this has been fairly routine in consent orders, and it's been routine even in non-consent orders, because now it will not be consentable So I would assume that SEBI will pass an order saying that whatever 2 crores or 5 crores, whatever has been wrongly made, should be handed over to the mutual fund to be in turn be credited to the accounts of the unit holders. So I think that should happen as a matter of course, and therefore I don't think there's a need for class action to take place, because SEBI kind of takes care of the interests of the investors, and this is of course in addition to the penalties which are imposed and not kind of substitute for the penalties.
All right, thanks very much, Sandeep Parekh, for joining me here. All right, the first time around, HDFC Mutual Fund closed the issue through a consent order passed by SEBI. Will it be second time lucky? Should the fund house apologize to its investors for the complete breakdown of checks and balances in curbing the activities of its rogue dealer? Should it do more to hold its top brass accountable? These are questions whose answers we will know in the days to come.